Hello and welcome back students. I'm Shruti Banerjee, your biology TGT teacher from Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Civil Lines, Raipur. In our previous lectures, we have already discussed about the different types of nutrition. In your notes, you have already studied that what is nutrition, why nutrition is important, and what are the different types of nutrition. In this session, we are again going to continue with that and study about human nutrition. So what is human nutrition? See, human beings are heterotrophs. Nutrition is of two types, autotrophs and heterotrophs. What are heterotrophs? Heterotrophs are the organism which depends upon other organism like other plants and other human other organisms for their nutritional source. Now these heterotrophs are again further divided, if you recall, into parasites, saprophytes and holozoic. So human beings belong to which category of heterotrophs? We belong to the category of holozoic mode of nutrition. What is holozoic mode of nutrition? It is a mode of nutrition in which the organism consumes a very complex type of food, okay? Food containing complex carbohydrates, complex fats and proteins. And the body of the holozoic organism break down these complex food into simpler forms so that they can be easily utilized by the organism. So this holozoic mode of nutrition has basically five different stages, or you can say it contains five different steps. Now what are they? The first step is ingestion. What happens in ingestion? Ingestion, the organism takes in the complex food. After ingestion comes the next step, that is digestion. What happens in digestion? The food which have been taken up breaks down into simpler molecules. After digestion, the next stage is absorption, where the digested simpler molecules are converted into simple molecules. Okay, so different organs of the body will absorb these digested molecules for their further utilization. And this utilizing process is known as assimilation. So after absorption comes the next step, that is assimilation, where the food is utilized by different organs for their growth, for their energy, for repair mechanism and so on. And the last stage of holozoic nutrition is egestion, where we see the undigested food, unrequired or the toxic materials present inside the food is removed from the body. So holozoic mode of nutrition is kind of an advanced nutrition process where complex food gets converted into simple molecules and it undergoes five different stages. So human beings belongs to which category? We belongs to heterotrophs and holozoic mode of nutrition. Now for having these five steps to occur smoothly in the body, human beings have a very complex organ system which is known as human digestive system. We are multicellular organisms and we see that different organs help in the complete process of nutrition. Okay, each of these specific organs and the enzymes released by these organs will perform the different duties for making the digestion process easy. So from where does this process starts? The digestion process or the nutritional process starts from the mouth. From mouth, the food moves to the next organ, that is esophagus. From esophagus, the food moves to the next organ, that is stomach. From stomach, we see the food enters the opening of small intestine, where it is joined by the enzymes given by the next organ, that is liver and pancreas, right? From here, the complete food material getting all the enzymes moves to the next organ, that is small intestine. From small intestine, it goes into the large intestine, and from large intestine, the undigested food is removed from the anal canal or the anus. So this complete digestive system you have already studied in lower classes. So what are you going to study in class 10th? In class 10th, we will be studying about the each and every specific role of these organs, how they assist the process of human digestion. Okay, how do they help in the nutrition of humans, right? So let's start one by one with each of these organs and their role in digestion. The first in the hand is mouth. Mouth or oral cavity, we see it consists of again different set of structures, that is buccal cavity, that is the set of teeth in the upper and the lower palate. It contains a tongue, and below the tongue there are present several glands. These glands together are known as salivary glands. See, salivary glands is again divided into three different types, and this picture is to help you just know where these glands are present. They are present below the tongue, means at the base of their mouth. Then some is present near the tonsil region, some is present near the ear region. Okay, but these glands are collectively known as salivary glands. So the mouth or the oral cavity, if it is asked, you will say it consists of two major assisting structures, that is buccal cavity, which will chew down the food into small pieces, and salivary gland, which will release saliva, which will again help in moistening the food. Apart from making the food soft, salivary gland releases a special type of enzyme known as salivary amylase. Very, very important, remember that. Salivary gland releases salivary amylase, which will break down the complex sugar like starch into simpler sugar. Okay, complex sugar into simpler sugar is converted by the salivary amylase. So you see, the digestion process have started from the mouth itself. That is why you are told that when you are eating, chew your food properly, let the saliva mix with that food, because if you do not break down the food properly or chew the food properly, it will not have the salivary amylase action on it, and in the further digestion process, the process will be incomplete or it will not be efficient. That is why you have to chew the food properly and then swallow it, right? So here in mouth, our buccal cavity has broken down the food, and salivary amylase has broken down the complex sugar into simpler sugar and made the food very soft. From mouth, the food will now enter the next organ, that is the esophagus. You can see here I have written two different spellings, one with starting from O and another with E. See, both the spellings are correct. Just to inform you, because in some books students have confusion. See, esophagus, O starting with O, the word is coming from British English, and esophagus, where the word, they have omitted the O and starts from E, it is American English. Both the spellings are correct, so don't get confused. So what is this esophagus organ? Esophagus organ is the tube from where the food is passed on to the next organ, that is stomach. Now this esophagus is also made up of muscles, and they have a specific type of movement known as peristalsis movement to push the food forward towards the stomach. How does this functions? You have taken the food, now it have entered the esophagus. So area where the food is present, the muscles around it will expand, and the muscles below and above that expanded area is contracted, right? Because of the contraction in the muscle, the food will be pushed forward. As the food has moved down, again the muscles above the food have contracted. So contraction, then expansion, again contraction, then expansion, and in this way the food is moved down. Okay, so this specific type of movement where the food is pushed, okay, from contraction, expansion, contraction, expansion, is known as peristalsis movement. Okay, now from the esophagus the food will enter the next organ, that is your stomach. The point where the esophagus joins the stomach is known as esophageal sphincter. Okay, so esophageal sphincter is nothing but a muscular gate which prevents the backflow of the food inside the stomach. After the food has entered the stomach, this sphincter will prevent it to move back. Okay, it will prevent it to move back to the esophagus. After entering the stomach, the food initiates the release of gastric juices. So what does stomach release? Stomach release gastric juices. And what does these juices contain? These juice contains very, very effective and highly concentrated hydrochloric acid, also known as HCl. And this gastric juice also contains an enzyme known as pepsin. So what is the role of this acid? This acid helps in the activation of enzyme pepsin. Okay, hydrochloric acid, without hydrochloric acid, pepsin will not get activated from pepsinogen. Okay, so the activation of pepsin requires the production of hydrochloric acid. But hydrochloric acid is again a highly concentrated acid, it can burn any organ. So to protect the stomach, how is stomach able to bear that acid? Because of a thick layer of mucus around. So stomach has three muscular layers. Of that, the most important layer is the mucus layer, which prevents the hydrochloric acid from burning its surface. Okay, and what is the action of enzyme pepsin? Pepsin will again help in breaking down proteins, specifically proteins. But you have to remember that in stomach also the food has now been partially digested. Complete digestion has not occurred. So let's have a recap. We saw that organism, human being, that is follows under holozoic mode of nutrition, which includes five steps. To assist in this process of nutrition, we have a special organ system which is known as digestive system. In that, we studied three major organs. One was the oral cavity, mouth, where it has buccal cavity and salivary gland. Okay, where it partially starts digesting with the help of salivary amylase from complex sugar to simpler sugars. Food passes down to the esophagus and finally goes into the stomach, where hydrochloric acid and pepsin start acting over it, right? And to protect the stomach, it has a layer of mucus. So I will suggest you to pause the video at several points and go through these important organs and their functions. It will be very helpful to you. For further organs, let's come back to the next video. Thank you for your patient listening. See you in the next video, and don't forget to stay safe.